Sometimes I get enough of having to listen to Nathan Oakley, Quantum Eraser, Widget Gets It, 10th Man and the like in order to make my videos. So I decided to look at Quantum Eraser's website, globeterminator.com. I saw the same old nonsense there in the childish layout with the silly emojis and the stupid pubescent insults, but at least I wouldn't have to listen to the irritating voice of this self-proclaimed genius. He posted 7 of what he calls his flat earth proofs. In a series of 7 videos, I will pulverize each and every one of them. This is part 5. ESSM Block 1 Sea Sparrow. This so-called proof requires some more information in order to understand how wrong Quantum Eraser is here. He starts off by stating that the Sea Sparrow is a surface-to-air and surface-to-surface radar-guided missile. Notice how he highlights the surface-to-surface part by blowing up the font size and changing the color to a shocking pink and underlining this part, whereas he keeps the surface-to-air part to the smallest font size. The link he gives is a dead one. But that's not important, it's the emphasis he gives to the surface-to-surface function of the Sea Sparrow. He needs this manipulating the perception of the reader in order to build up his giant straw man. The missile system requires a line of sight, as QE states, although the link he provides is a dead one. And he is right this time. Then he continues with giving the range of the missile as being 35 miles. The link he provides refers to a paper that starts off with presenting the system as a surface-to-air defense system, and only later on it says in small print that it also can be used as a surface-to-surface defense system. The emphasis of the Navy is quite different from QE's one. In the very same paper, we can see that the range given is 50 kilometers. That's only 31 miles. But hey, calculation isn't QE's forte. And it says that the range of the missile is 50 kilometers. This does in no way mean that the surface-to-surface ability of the system has a range of 50 kilometers. And it can't have, as Quantum Eraser calculates. But the Navy never said that the surface-to-surface range is 50 kilometers. QE suggests that the Navy has done so, but he is flat out lying. Of course, as usual, he ends with his modus tollens argumentation and introduces another blatant lie. Not Q, surface targets are illuminated, then engaged at distances over 4 times that limit. The statement that the surface-to-surface range is more than the line of sight distance on a globe Earth, that is 50 kilometers, is nowhere to be found, because it doesn't exist.
How stupid can anyone be?
Oh well, it's just Quantum Eraser, who definitely has deserved his nickname, Questionable Education.